A Windward Oahu lagoon where many people paddle and fish has become a breeding ground for high levels of bacteria. The Department of Health wants people to stay out of the Kahaluu Lagoon and the channel leading to Kaneohe Bay after water samples showed unusually high levels of bacteria. They think the water is contaminated with sewage, but they don't know where it came from. And if it weren't for concerned residents, the problem may have gone unnoticed. Brent Ramadna got answers on how bad the contamination is. Brent?
Joe, I was told that the bacteria in this specific area had levels that were 10 times higher than normal. And residents say it's so bad people were getting infections from the water. They started reporting it months ago, and today the state put up warning signs.
During one of our summer meetings, the residents came to report that the canoe paddlers were getting cut keels or open sores and infections.
Shortly after that meeting in July, Kahaluu Neighborhood Board member Flora Obayashi reached out to the Department of Health after numerous complaints of people that were entering the water. In September, the DOH started testing the water.
On a clean beach, on a bright sunny day, we'll find bacteria levels in the 10s or 20s, maybe up to 100.
That's pretty normal. But the levels they're finding now are raising some concerns.
Now we're finding it in the thousands in the lagoon.
The high levels have now prompted the DOH to bring out signs like this, which urge the public to stay out of the water.
We haven't seen this level of high bacteria anywhere else around the island. It's almost equivalent to what we saw in the Alawai Canal when there was the huge sewage spill 5 years ago.
And while signs have now been posted, a fisherman who wished to remain anonymous says those signs should have been posted much earlier.
Finally today they came over. I asked them, oh, what is this? How long did you guys know? He said 1 month. And only now you guys putting up the sign? Why didn't you guys say something before that?
So what's causing the high bacteria levels? Well, the DOH is still trying to find the source, but there are some theories.
Because we're in a rural area, we're not on the county sewage system. Every homeowner along the street has to maintain a cesspool or a septic tank.
And those cesspools could be contributing to the unusually high bacteria levels. But until they know for sure, the problem can't be addressed.
Well, I think this is an urgent health situation for the community, but I think it's not likely to be resolved anytime in the next few weeks.
In fact, it could take years.
This is something that is likely going to have to go on for a number of years.
And people with open wounds or weakened immune systems are especially at risk for infection in these waters. So again, just stay out of the water. And we will be following up to find out what caused the high levels and what the Department of Health plans to do next. Brent Ramadna, KHON 2 News.